Swing low, sweet chariot, coming far to carry me home. Swing.
It was on his grave, my friends, that I resolved before God that I would never own another slave while it is possible to free him, that nobody through me should ever run the risk of being parted from home and friends and dying on a lonely plantation as he died. So, when you rejoice in your freedom, think that you owe it to that good old soul and pay it back in kindness to his wife and children. Think of your freedom every time you see Uncle Tom's cabin, and let it be a memorial to put you all in mind to follow in his steps and be as honest and faithful and Christian as he was.
Dear friend, I'm writing to tell you that I am boycotting slave-made sugar and cotton after listening to the heartbreaking but true story of Uncle Tom's Cabin. The reason I am not using sugar and cotton is that it is made by slaves who have had their status as human beings ripped away by cruel slave traders. Our kind are being treated like possessions. They can be killed and it is not murder. There is but few people that speak out against this injustice. We must change that. So please, friend, help me put an end to the unfairness and make hundreds of lives worth living. Best wishes, Aidan McKenna.
Dear friend, as you are well aware of, I am writing about my recent excursion. Upon my reflection, you'll understand, as my good friend, I must urge you to give up your prized cottons because, of course, this is a heavy subject weighing down on all our shoulders. I can report firsthand on how tense and uncomfortable the atmosphere was at the gathered crowd listening in to the heartbreakingly honest book, Uncle Tom's Cabin. This in itself is proof of my earlier statement to be true. Now, as a respectable man like yourself, you may feel outraged at this suggestion, but I assure you, a problem, a cruelty, such as slavery is a matter that must be overcome. I plead you to consider this plight. Give up sugar, say, or perhaps be kind enough to give up cotton. You could make the year of every slave. Yours truly, Helena.
Dear friend, today I listened to a public reading of Uncle Tom's Cabin, and I have decided after careful consideration that we should not eat sugar or wear cotton because the slaves that make these things are treated like pets. Evil owners can sell their children to anyone and kill the slaves, and it's not illegal. It's classed as disposing of your property. The owners will whip the slaves if they are not working well and they do not get days off. From Thomas.
Dear friend, hearing the story of Uncle Tom's Cabin for the first time changed my point of view for black people a lot. Slaves really go through a lot. They get beaten daily and can be murdered without charge. It's just thought of as disposing property. They make all these things for us and we don't even thank them. Cotton, wool, sugar, and even houses. I can't believe how they're treated. They fight so hard and not a word they say gets listened to. If they run away from such terrible treatment, a bounty gets placed on their head. You really need to help me boycott against this. Throw away all of your cotton clothes and don't buy any more. Just stop eating sugar. You can probably use more of it than you think. Together, my friend, we can travel to America and raise awareness of this. They use many thousands of slaves. We will give them money to pay their masters for better treatment, and I repeat again, we must stop this. Together we can change the point of view for black slaves everywhere. Yours in solidarity, Monty.
Dear friend, I would like to inform you of the way that black slaves are treated all around the world. All slaves are put to work from very young ages and work all their lives. They are beaten and forced to work, as I learned in the book reading of Uncle Tom's Cabin this morning. Children are separated from their mothers and family and sold as things. This is why I ask you not to buy sugar or cotton to help slaves and make the slave traders have less income. I strongly believe that slavery is wrong and you not buying sugar and cotton will help to end slavery. Yours faithfully, Alice.
Two white horses side by side. Come in here and take me higher out here. Rock me along, slow and easy. I've got a home on the other side.